Hello everyone, today I'll be reviewing the Anycubic Photon M7 Pro Resin 3D Printer. Years ago, on a hot summer day, I bought my first resin 3D printer and, despite my inexperience, tried to get good prints. Although I made some errors, I finally achieved a successful result and was able to create a review video. That printer was the Photon S model from the Anycubic brand. 5 years have passed, and I haven't reviewed a single Anycubic printer in all that time. Of course, with the release of new models, requests from you have started to increase, and I didn't want to leave these requests unfulfilled. Today's guest is the Anycubic Photon M7 Pro. As you can see, the device has a dark gray body with a matching UV retarder cover. There are also some small orange accents. The 4.3-inch color touchscreen underneath works very well. I'd say its sensitivity is as high as a phone or tablet. While its exterior may seem no different from standard resin printers, the real important hardware is inside. When we lift the lid, we see a large resin chamber. The chamber houses a special ACF film developed by Anycubic. This film reduces resistance to the model during printing, allowing for a higher print success rate. A resin heater is located in the left corner of the chamber. This system allows you to manually warm up the resin before printing or automatically control the temperature during printing, maintaining a constant resin temperature. Looking to the right corner of the chamber, we see the automatic resin filling system. This module, which can be connected directly to the resin bottle, allows you to fill and empty the chamber with a single click from the menu. Alternatively, when you activate automatic filling, the printer automatically adjusts the amount of resin needed for each print. Beneath the resin chamber is a 10.1-inch, 14K resolution mono LCD screen. This screen offers a resolution of 16.8 by 24.8 microns in the XY axis. With the M7 Pro, we can print prints up to 223 by 126 millimeters wide and deep, and up to 230 millimeters high, in one piece. The M7 Pro is a fast resin printer. It can reach speeds of 130 millimeters sec with standard resin and 170 millimeters sec with high-speed resin. The device features wireless connectivity. This feature allows you to send sliced models to the printer using its own slicing software, start printing, or adjust print settings. These settings can also be accessed from your phone or tablet using the Anycubic app. I'd like to briefly mention the wash cure machine. It features a small but very useful feature beyond the standard. A graduated basket is included in the wash section for washing models along with the table. Depending on the model's length, you can position your table in the middle or high section. In the curing section, you can cure models in either a single layer or two, depending on their quantity and size. This is especially useful if your prints are small or have many parts. Additionally, an ultraviolet light has been integrated into the device, which you can move in any direction. Of course, it's a significant improvement over the Anycubic Photon S, which I first reviewed. Naturally, this resin loading and unloading system, or rather the resin heater, is one of the most important features of this device, and it also has an automatic Z offset adjustment. I'll discuss this later in the video. I'll also provide a review of the device at the end. But first, let's take a look at the prints I made. There were 4 test prints inside the printer. 2 of them were decorative items. One was a functional piece that made it easier to unload the resin. One was a speed test. I actually wanted to run this speed test even though I had standard resin on hand. Fast resins are different and cure much faster. Despite this, I ran the speed test even with standard resin and didn't encounter any problems. As you can see, this model, at the printer's maximum print height, which is 25 centimeters, was printed in just 2 hours and 17 minutes. Frankly, I was skeptical about the print success. The table moves up and down so quickly, meaning the curing time was very short, and I figured I'd definitely encounter a problem. But it didn't work as I expected. I'll show you the image. This image was taken without speeding up. As you can see, the table goes down, cures, and then comes back up. I was impressed with the speed and quality of printing with standard resin from the very first print. I have to say that, immediately afterward, I printed two decorative items from memory. A small dragon and a wolf model. The details are excellent. Layer marks are completely unnoticeable. This dragon model, in particular, was a challenging model to print in one piece, but I managed to print both without any problems. The third piece is the functional model I mentioned earlier. They included a test model to make things easier during the resin pouring process. This one also prints very well. After these were finished, I printed three test models. One, as I've always said before, is the benchmark of resin printers. Despite being smaller than a small coin, it has a wealth of detail, and all of it is perfectly reproduced, down to the smallest detail. I also ran another test with very small details, text, and textures. There are also some unsupported, angled pieces. All the prints turned out beautifully. There were no issues with this test model either. The other was a small cube-shaped test model he used in the past. All of these turned out beautifully. Just looking at the test models, we can already see how fast and high quality the printer can produce, and how detailed it can be. However, of course, the vast majority of people buying resin printers are those who also work with these types of figures. Of course, they're also used in engineering and dental fields, but hobbyists probably make up the vast majority of resin printer users. I also printed two figures. One of them is a miniature. Frankly, before purchasing the print, I thought it would be a bit larger, but it turned out quite small. Despite its small size, the details are still very clear, even if not very detailed. There are no printing errors. Layer marks are practically invisible anymore. In other words, with devices with such a high resolution screen and such precision in the Z-axis, I didn't notice any layer marks. It's an extremely successful print. For my next print, I wanted to see the fine details and textures we saw on these test models also on a hobby object like this, so I printed this model. As you can see, there's a lot of detail, and it all turned out beautifully. I didn't notice any printing errors. The fine patterns and sharp points on that axe are particularly impressive. The detail, the pattern, the sharpness constantly pushed me to make more challenging prints, and I printed this Notre Dame Cathedral print. You'll see that some spots remain shiny because I rushed the cleaning process. If you don't clean a model properly, shiny areas can remain. Keep that in mind, but of course, that's not what I really want to show. Those tiny, pointed details you see are the fine, patterned parts of the cathedral's Gothic structure. This is quite a challenging print for a resin printer. The ability to reproduce such fine detail without tearing is a clear testament to the high-resolution screen and the precision of the Z-axis. I'll zoom in and show you a few details, especially. There are vertical lines on the back of the cathedral. It's like a balcony railing. These are millimeter thin pieces, aren't they? They turned out fantastic. I also want you to take a closer look at the details of that window at the back. Similarly, there are very finely detailed, patterned windows on the left and right sides, and they're perfect. There's not a single problem. There are door details on the left and right sides. He's perfectly captured every detail, even the door's patterns. Of course, it's nice to see details on figures like this, but I was able to show you exactly what I wanted to show on this model, or perhaps it would have failed. We were going to say he couldn't go into this much detail, but as you can see, he printed it beautifully without the slightest problem. I even said, let me make this model the standard. So, from now on, I'll print the same model on the resin printers I'll be reviewing, so you can use it as a reference when making comparisons with other resin printers. At least we have one model fixed. I can compare how well one produced, whether the other produced better, or whether it didn't. Of course, my prints weren't always successful. I had some disappointing results. I'd like to briefly explain them, along with the reasons why. I wanted to print a few technical pieces. Some of these were okay, but a large majority already had flaws, or even the models I deemed okay had flaws in certain areas. Some of these lacked support. The model didn't adhere well enough to the painting, or there were lines between the layers. I can list the reasons as follows. First of all, I used Anycubic standard resin on all previous models. Here, I used a different brand of resin and didn't change the settings. So, you've seen how fast it is and how fast it prints. I decided to try it here, to see if I could get the same performance with a different brand of resin. But of course, this was also amateurish. Every resin has its own exposure settings. You can't get the same quality prints with the same exposure settings on every resin. Another important point is the support settings. I adjusted the support settings for all the parts you see myself. For example, on this model, it wasn't sufficient. The model looked good up to a certain point. After that, the lines increased. Structural deterioration began. This was because the supports were inadequate in this area. So, my advice for anyone looking to print with resin for the first time is, for example, did you buy the M7 Pro? Make sure to use the smallest resin you can find for your first prints. Do you want to try a different brand or type of resin later? Research its parameters as well. Ask the manufacturers. Know your exposure times. Otherwise, like I did, you'll encounter these kinds of problems with incorrect support settings and exposure times. New users often assume these problems are due to the machine itself, but the problems are either related to these or to the table leveling. Experienced users are certainly aware of what I'm saying. However, I wanted to offer a little advice for new users. I found the M7 Pro's print quality to be excellent. It reproduces very fine and sharp details beautifully. Therefore, I believe this printer can be used in a wide range of fields, from hobbyists and engineering to dental and jewelry. One of the most important aspects of precision is, of course, the Z-axis. The use of dual linear rails in this printer, with its relatively large table, is extremely logical. The Z-axis motor is also very quiet. The ACF film they use offers no resistance to the model, so the printer emits almost no noise other than the fan. The wireless connection works well on both computers and phones, but without a camera, that connection is frankly lacking. There's not much room left for a camera either. Perhaps a small camera could have been placed in a specific area of that heater on the back right. I wish it had. I like the automatic filling feature. I used it for the first time, and it made my job much easier, especially when pouring resin. Of course, the table isn't spotless during pouring. You have to scoop the resin into the corner with a spatula, but it's much better than removing the resin container and tipping it into the bottle. It also stops printing and warns you if the amount of resin in the bottle is insufficient during printing. The only drawback is that you can't attach an air filter to the device. Well, we can, but to do so, we have to remove the automatic filling and emptying system. However, if you want to connect the device to a separate air purifier, the printer has a dedicated exhaust fan. This is very important for health. Please be careful. First of all, resin is toxic and can be dangerous if it comes into contact with skin. In addition, during use, the resin releases volatile organic compounds, VOX, which we abbreviate as VOC, into the air, and breathing them is harmful to your health. Therefore, when working with the printer, you should always wear protective gloves and masks with filters that can filter these VOX. Of course, the printer's environment should be well ventilated. The table leveling works very well. As I mentioned, it's not a table leveling, but an automatic Z offset adjustment. This is preset from the factory, eliminating the need for any table leveling. If you drop the table, or if there's debris on the table, or if something happens that results in unsuccessful prints, you'll need to readjust it. You need to adjust it manually. After making the manual adjustment, it automatically adjusts the Z offset, its proximity to, and distance from the table. The Z offset adjustment isn't the only feature of this system. If excessive pressure is applied to the table, it immediately stops printing, thus preventing damage to the ACF film and LCD screen. As I mentioned at the beginning, I haven't used a top-tier resin printer in a long time. Over this long period, there have been significant improvements in both print quality and ease of use. The slicing software has also become faster, and the settings have become more detailed. The wash and cure device makes your job much easier and reduces your contact with the chemicals I mentioned earlier. Therefore, I recommend that anyone considering this printer budget for a wash and cure device. I think if you're looking for a high-resolution, comfortable, and easy-to-use resin printer, the M7 Pro is a highly recommended device. That's all I have to say about this printer. I hope this video was helpful and gave you some insight into these devices. I'd appreciate it if you could share your thoughts on both this video and the devices in the comments section. May your printer be trouble-free and your prints flawless. See you in the next video. Goodbye.
Sonraki videoda görüşmek üzere. Hoşça kalın.